when these tapes, these 90 hours of tapes that had been in this closet, landed on my conscience, I think that you were the first person I thought of. And you're an incredible editor. And for those that are out there, like, if you see Rob Kirwan on a PBS show, watch it. It's going to be really good. But I think that it was really, you know, I was thinking more in terms of your listening ability and your humanity, and that this would take both and strength of character. This was going to take more than film skills to do. And you were also working with a first-time director. So I thought, knowing me would be an advantage for you. What do you remember first hearing about this, and how you heard about it? And
I just remember you coming over to the Powder House office where I was working at the time on a project, and you told me about these tapes in a closet, and that immediately sparked my interest. Then you told me what was on the tapes, and the fact that no one had really seen those for a couple of decades at least, and that somebody had gone through the painstaking care to record these testimonies of Holocaust first person witness accounts. That sounded like a treasure trove of amazing emotional stories. I've been working a lot in the business for, you know, 27 years now, and it's not that often you come across very powerful emotional material. So when I heard about these tapes and I started imagining what was on them, I realized that it may be an incredible opportunity to tell amazing, emotionally impactful stories. And that really got me excited. And also working with you, Harvey, was something I really looked forward to. And I knew that you would approach the material first and foremost from a human side, a humanistic perspective.